we will study about the sole of the foot, we have the dissected specimens of the left lower limb. Skin over the sole of the foot, it is very thick, and regarding the cutaneous nerve supply over the plantar surface of the sole, we can see from this diagram, the whole of the skin over the plantar surface, it is supplied by various branches of the tibial nerve, except for the medial border where it is supplied by the saphenous nerve, a branch from the femoral nerve. Now the various branches which are supplying the plantar surface of sole, they are first the anterior and the medial part of the sole, it is supplied by medial plantar branch of the tibial nerve. This medial plantar nerve, it will also supply the skin over the plantar surface of medial 3.5 toes. The lateral part of the sole of the foot, it will be supplied by the lateral branches of the tibial nerve, and these lateral plantar nerve, they will also supply the plantar surface of the lateral 1.5 toe. The medial and the lateral borders of the sole, the medial border, it is supplied by the saphenous nerve, a branch from the femoral nerve, and the lateral border, it is supplied by the sural nerve, a branch from the tibial nerve. But the heel over the sole, it is supplied by the medial calcaneal branches of the tibial nerve. So various branches of the tibial nerve, they will supply the sole, except at the medial border where it is supplied by saphenous branch of the femoral nerve. Regarding the dermatomes over the sole of the foot, the medial part of the sole of the foot, it is supplied by the L5 segment, and rest of the heel and the lateral part of the sole, it is by the S1 segment of the spinal cord. Except over a part of the medial border, it will be by the L4 segment of the spinal cord. So the dermatomes, they can be marked as mainly by the L5 and S1, except near the medial border by the L4 dermatome. Once we reflect the skin, deep to the skin is the thick, dense superficial fascia, and deep to the superficial fascia is the deep fascia. The deep fascia on the sole, it is thickened in the central part to form a triangular plantar aponeurosis. The apex of the plantar aponeurosis, it is attached to the medial process of the calcaneal tuberosity, and the base of the plantar aponeurosis, it splits into 5 processes. The medialmost process of the plantar aponeurosis, it will pass to the great toe. Each process of the plantar aponeurosis, it will further split up into 2, a superficial and a deep part. In between the various processes, we can see the digital nerves and vessels which are passing. The plantar aponeurosis, it differs from the palmar aponeurosis of the hand in the sense that in the palmar aponeurosis, we have only the 4 slips for the palmar aponeurosis, but in the plantar aponeurosis, the slip which is passing to the great toe, it will restrict the mobility of the great toe. From the medial and the lateral border of plantar aponeurosis, there are present medial and the lateral vertical intermuscular septas. These medial and the lateral intermuscular septas, they divide the whole of the sole into 3 compartments. The medialmost compartment for the muscles of the great toe, the lateralmost compartment for the muscles of the little toe, and in the central or intermediate compartment, we have the lumbricals and introcii muscles and the digital flexors. In addition to medial and the lateral vertical intermuscular septa, the transverse septa passes from these vertical septa, and these transverse septa, they divide the whole of the compartments of the sole into 4 layers in which the muscles, they are present and the neurovascular planes are present. The plantar aponeurosis is a separated tendon of the plantaris muscle which has become separated due to development of the heel. Reflect the plantar aponeurosis, we can see the muscles of the sole, and these muscles, they are arranged in 4 layers. The first, we are studying the first layer of the muscles. We have reflected the plantar aponeurosis, and now we can see these 3 muscles in the first layer of the sole, and all these muscles in the first layer, they will take origin from the calcaneal tuberosity and from the plantar aponeurosis. First, we will see the diagram of these muscles from the Natter's Atlas. Here we can see clearly the arrangement of the muscle. The medial most muscle, it is for the great toe, and this is abductor hallucis muscle. The lateral most muscle, it is for the little toe. This is abductor digiti minimi muscle. And in the center, we have the muscle flexor digitorum brevis. Now we can identify these three muscles in the dissection. Here we can see the medial most muscle, abductor hallucis. In the center, this is flexor digitorum brevis, and the third muscle, this is the abductor digiti minimi. Now about the origin and insertions of these muscles. First, about the abductor hallucis muscle. This muscle will take origin from the medial process of calcaneal tuberosity, and the tendon will be inserted onto the medial side of the base of the proximal phalanx of the great toe. So we can see the calcaneal tuberosity from the bone also. I have the left calcaneum bone, and this one is the dorsal surface, and here is the plantar surface. And this is the calcaneal tuberosity with its medial and the lateral process. From the medial process, the abductor hallucis and the flexor digitorum brevis, they will take origin. And from the lateral process, the abductor digiti minimi will take origin. Now the second muscle, the flexor digitorum brevis, origin is from the medial process of calcaneal tuberosity, and tendon of flexor digitorum brevis, it will divide into four, and each tendon will again divide into two slips, and these two slips, they will enclose the tendon of flexor digitorum longus in between them. The flexor digitorum brevis, it is equivalent to the flexor digitorum superficialis muscle of the hand. So this is the flexor digitorum brevis attached to calcaneum, and these are the four tendons of the flexor digitorum brevis muscle, and each tendon will further divide into two slips to enclose the flexor digitorum longus muscle. The third muscle in the first layer, this is the abductor digiti minimi, taking origin from the lateral process of calcaneal tuberosity, and it is inserted onto the lateral side of the base of the proximal phalanx of the little toe. So these are the three muscles in the first layer of the sole. So once we reflect the first layer of muscles, in between the first and second layer of muscles lies the first neurovascular plane of the sole. And this neurovascular plane, it is formed by the medial plantar nerve and medial plantar artery and vein, and also by the lateral plantar nerve and lateral plantar artery. Both the medial and the lateral plantar nerve, they are branches from the tibial nerve, while the medial and the lateral plantar arteries, they are branches from the posterior tibial artery. We will study the distribution of these in the last part of this video. First, we will identify the muscles in the second layer of the sole. In the second layer of muscles, we have the long flexor tendons which are passing from the back of the leg. The first tendon, which is from the back of the leg, for the great toe, it is the flexor hallucis longus. The second tendon, it is of the flexor digitorum longus, and from the medial side of the flexor digitorum longus arises the lumbrical muscles. And the fourth muscle in the second layer, it is the flexor digitorum accessorius muscle attached to the flexor digitorum longus. So these are the four muscles in the second layer: flexor hallucis longus, flexor digitorum longus, lumbrical muscles, and flexor digitorum accessorius muscles. Now we can see these muscles in the dissection. So here we can identify the first muscle for the great toe, that is the flexor hallucis longus. Then the second, this is the flexor digitorum longus, and along the medial side of flexor digitorum longus lies the lumbrical muscles, and fourth muscle is the flexor digitorum accessorius muscle attached to the flexor digitorum longus. Now regarding the origin and insertion of these muscles, the flexor hallucis longus, it is a muscle from posterior compartment of the leg taking origin from the posterior surface of the fibula, and it will pass beneath the flexor retinaculum, and the tendon, it will be inserted up to the base of the distal phalanx of the great toe. So this is the flexor hallucis longus. The second muscle, this is the flexor digitorum longus. This is again a muscle from the posterior compartment of the leg, and the tendon, it will also pass beneath the flexor retinaculum to enter into the sole. And we can see here that the flexor digitorum longus, it is crossing the tendon of flexor hallucis longus superficially, and the tendon of flexor digitorum longus, it will divide in further into four tendons for the lateral four toes, and these tendons, they will be attached to the base of the distal phalanx of the lateral four toes. From the medial side of the flexor digitorum longus tendon arises the lumbrical muscles. There are total four lumbricals counted from the medial side. First, this is second, third and fourth lumbrical. And first lumbrical is unipinnate in nature, while the second, third and the fourth lumbricals, they are bipinnate in nature. So flexor digitorum longus muscle, it is equivalent to the flexor digitorum profundus muscle of the hand. The fourth muscle in this group, it is the flexor digitorum accessorius muscle. This muscle take origin from two heads. One is the medial head and a lateral head. Origin we can see from the calcaneum bone. So this is the plantar surface of the left calcaneum, and this is the medial surface of the calcaneum. The medial head of the flexor digitorum accessorius, it will take origin from the medial surface of the calcaneum, while the lateral head, it will take origin from the lateral process of calcaneal tuberosity. And both the heads, they will join and they will be inserted onto the lateral side of the tendon of flexor digitorum longus muscle. And on the calcaneum bone, another feature we can see here, this is the sustentaculum tali. And on the plantar surface of sustentaculum tali, there is a groove for the tendon of flexor hallucis longus muscle. Regarding the insertion and action of lumbrical muscles, all the lumbricals, they are inserted onto the dorsal digital expansion. And action of lumbrical muscles, they will cause plantar flexion at metatarsophalangeal joint and dorsiflexion at the interphalangeal joint. So this was the second layer of muscles where there are all the long flexors are present. Now we move on to the third layer of muscles where we can see the short flexors which are confined to the metatarsal regions. And in this region we will first see the diagram from the atlas. First muscle on the medial side, it is the flexor hallucis brevis muscle, a short muscle. The second in the center part, it is the adductor hallucis having an oblique and transverse head. The third muscle of this group, it is for the little toe, that is the flexor digiti minimi brevis muscle. Now we can see these three muscles in the dissection. First from the medial side, this is the flexor hallucis brevis. Second muscle, adductor hallucis. And third, this is the flexor digiti minimi brevis muscle. Now, origin and insertion of these muscles. First, about the flexor hallucis brevis muscle. The origin of flexor hallucis brevis, it is having a Y-shaped attachment, a medial and a lateral limb of the Y. The medial limb of the Y, it is attached to the tendon of tibialis posterior muscle. The lateral limb of the Y-shaped attachment, it is to the plantar surface of the cuboid bone. The flexor hallucis brevis muscle, it will also end up into a two parts, a medial and a lateral part. And both the parts, they are attached on either side of the base of the proximal phalanx of the great toe. And each of the part, there is present a sesamoid bone. Next muscle in this group, it is the adductor hallucis muscle, equivalent to the adductor pollicis of the thumb in hand. The adductor hallucis muscle, it is having an oblique and a transverse head. The oblique head of adductor hallucis, it will take origin from the base of second, third and fourth metatarsal bones, while the transverse head, it will take origin from the deep metatarsophalangeal ligament. And both the heads, they will join and they will be inserted onto the lateral side of the base of proximal phalanx of the great toe. The third muscle in this group, this is the flexor digiti minimi brevis. It will take origin from the base of fifth metatarsal and insertion will be onto the lateral side of the base of proximal phalanx of little toe. So these are the three muscles in the third layer from medial to lateral side: flexor hallucis brevis, adductor hallucis, and third is the flexor digiti minimi brevis muscle. Now about the fourth layer of muscles in the sole. In the fourth layer of muscles, there are introcii muscles, three plantar introcii and four dorsal introcii muscle. First about the plantar introcii muscle. All the plantar introcii muscles, they are unipinnate in nature, and there are total three plantar introcii counted from medial side. This is first, second and third plantar introcii. And movements in the toe, in foot, they are considered in relation to the second metatarsal bone. So any movement of the toes towards the second metatarsal bone, it will be regarded as the adduction movement, and any movement away from the second toe, it will be the abduction movement. And movement of the second toe in any direction, it will be regarded as the abduction. And function of plantar introcii, they will cause the adduction of the toes, and since the second movement of second toe in any direction, it is called as abduction, so there will be no plantar introcii attached to the second metatarsal bone. And for the first toe, we have the single muscle, that is the adductor hallucis muscle in the third layer, which will cause the function of adduction of the great toe. So these are the three plantar introcii and their function, and we can see now these plantar introcii in the dissection also. So here in the dissection, we can see these three plantar introcii from medial to lateral side. This is the first, then second and the third plantar introcii. All are unipinnate in nature. Now about the dorsal introcii muscles. There are total four dorsal introcii counted from medial side, first, second, third and fourth dorsal introcii. Since the movement of the second toe in any direction, it is the abduction, so there are two dorsal introcii attached to the second metatarsal bone, and all the dorsal introcii, they are bipinnate in nature as compared to the plantar introcii, which are all unipinnate in nature. So now we can see in the dissection the dorsal introcii muscle. This is the right foot. So here we can see this first dorsal introcii, second dorsal introcii, both are attached to the second metatarsal bone. This is third and the fourth dorsal introcii. All the plantar and the dorsal introcii, they are inserted onto the dorsal digital expansion. Regarding the vessels and the nerves in the various muscles of the sole, so first we can identify here, this is the medial plantar nerve and the medial plantar artery. And this is the lateral plantar nerve and the lateral plantar artery. The medial plantar artery, it is lying medial to the medial plantar nerve, while the lateral plantar artery, it is lying lateral to the lateral plantar nerve. So both the nerves, they are lying in between the two arteries. The medial and the lateral plantar arteries, they are the branches from the posterior tibial artery, while the medial and the lateral plantar nerve, they are branches from the tibial nerve. The first neurovascular plane in the sole, it is lying between the first and the second layer of muscles, but the deep branches of the lateral plantar nerve and the lateral plantar artery, which is forming the plantar arch, it is lying between the third and the fourth layer of muscles of the sole. So first neurovascular plane in the sole, it is between the first and second layer, while the second neurovascular plane, it is between the third and fourth layer of muscles of the sole.
Now regarding the distribution of the medial plantar nerve. The medial plantar nerve, it is the larger terminal branch of the tibial nerve. The course of the medial plantar nerve is, here we can see that the medial plantar nerve, it is accompanied by the medial plantar artery on its medial side. The nerve, it runs first deep to the abductor hallucis muscle, and then it runs forward between the abductor hallucis and the flexor digitorum brevis muscle. The nerve, it terminates by dividing into one proper plantar digital and three common plantar digital nerves. Now, the various muscles and the part of the skin which are supplied by the medial plantar nerve are near its origin. The medial plantar nerve, it will supply the abductor hallucis and the flexor digitorum brevis muscle of the first layer of the sole. Then it gives branches to the medial side of the skin, and the proper plantar digital nerve from the medial plantar nerve, it will supply the flexor hallucis brevis muscle, and also it will supply the skin on the medial side of the great toe. The three common plantar digital nerve, they each will divide into two proper plantar digital nerves. And these proper plantar digital nerves, they will supply the skin on the adjacent side of the medial 3.5 toes. And the first common plantar digital nerve, it will also supply the first lumbrical muscle. The plantar digital nerve from the medial plantar nerve, they will also give up dorsal digital branches, which will supply the skin on around the nail bed on the dorsum of the foot. So the medial plantar nerve, in total, it supplies four muscles: the abductor hallucis, flexor digitorum brevis, flexor hallucis brevis, and the first lumbrical muscle. And cutaneous part, which is being supplied by medial plantar nerve, as we can see in the second diagram, it will supply the skin on the anterior and the medial part of the sole, and also the plantar surface of medial 3.5 digits. And by its dorsal digital branches, it will also supply the skin around the nail bed. So the medial plantar nerve, it is equivalent in its distribution to the median nerve of the hand. Now about the lateral plantar nerve. Lateral plantar nerve is the smaller branch of the tibial nerve. The course of the lateral plantar nerve is, here we can see that the lateral plantar nerve, it is accompanied by the lateral plantar artery on its lateral side. The lateral plantar nerve, it will run first deep to the abductor hallucis muscle, then it will run forward between the flexor digitorum accessorius and the flexor digitorum brevis muscle. The nerve, it will further run forward on the lateral side of the sole of the foot, and near the base of fifth metatarsal bone, it will divide into a superficial and a deep branch. The deep branch of the lateral plantar nerve, it will run in the concavity formed by the plantar arch, which is a continuation from the lateral plantar artery. So the course of the lateral plantar nerve, it is similar to the ulnar nerve of the hand. Now the distribution of the lateral plantar nerve to various muscles and skin will be as, near its origin, from the trunk of the lateral plantar nerve, the two muscles which are supplied, they are the abductor digiti minimi and the flexor digitorum accessorius muscle. Then the nerve runs forward, giving cutaneous branches to the lateral side of the sole of the foot. Now the superficial branch of the lateral plantar nerve, it further divides into a lateral and a medial branch. The lateral branch, it will supply the muscles flexor digiti minimi brevis muscle and the introcii muscles, which are present in the fourth intermetatarsal space. And the two introcii in this fourth space, they are the third plantar introcii and the fourth dorsal introcii. The lateral terminal branch, it will also supply the skin on the lateral side of the little toe. The medial branch from this superficial branch, it will divide into the plantar digital nerves, which will supply the skin on the adjacent side of the fourth and the fifth toe. So the superficial branch from its lateral division, it will supply the flexor digiti minimi brevis, two introcii that are the third plantar and fourth dorsal introcii. muscle and also skin on the lateral side of the little toe. From its medial branch, it will supply the skin on the adjacent side of fourth and fifth toe. The deep branch of the lateral plantar nerve, it is accompanied by the plantar arch of the lateral plantar artery. This deep branch, it will supply the dorsal and the plantar introtii, and the dorsal introtii, which are being supplied by deep branch, they are the first, second, and the third dorsal introtii, and the plantar introtii, first and the second plantar introtii, they will be supplied by the deep branch of the lateral plantar nerve. In addition, this deep branch, it will supply the adductor hallucis muscle and the second, third, and the fourth lumbrical muscle. The first lumbrical muscle, it is being supplied by the branches of medial plantar nerve. And regarding the cutaneous distribution of the lateral plantar nerve, as we see in the second diagram, the lateral plantar nerve, it will supply the skin on the lateral side of the sole of the foot and also the plantar surface of the lateral one and a half toe. The digital branches from the lateral plantar nerve, they will also pass on the dorsum of the foot to supply on the skin around the nail bed. So the lateral plantar nerve, which is equivalent to the ulnar nerve of the hand, it will supply the all the introtii and the lumbrical muscles except for the first lumbrical muscle, and it will supply the other muscles which are being supplied by lateral plantar nerve. They are the flexor digiti minimi brevis, abductor digiti minimi, and the flexor digitorum accessorius muscle.